Remember last year, this group, many of the athletes in this room were part of the highest finish in the history of this university in the Learfield Cup competition. We finished third in the nation. That's extraordinary. We should be very, very proud of that. And I personally think we're going to finish higher even this year. So give yourselves a round of applause. Different sports, different genders, different age groups, different parts of the country, different majors. You can go down the line. But as you can see in this room, we're all part of one team. We're all part of one team. That's very, very important to understand. Your actions, your decisions, your choices are bigger than just you because of that. You know that we lost I'm probably not emphasizing enough, a very key big part of our athletic program last week. You got, many of you knew her as Miss Beverly Steele. Probably one of the hardest working, toughest people I've ever been associated with over the course of my life. She loved all the athletes, all the teams, followed every one of you. And I promise you, I talked to her in the last week of her life, and all she was really concerned about was getting this year started right for you guys. So, very, very key individual to our success and to your success we lost.
So I want y'all to do something for me. Say, character counts.
Character counts.
Say it like you mean it. Say, character counts.
Character counts.
One more time. Character counts.
Character counts.
Right. So tonight, I want to talk to you a little about character. How many of y'all are familiar with the concept of the iceberg? Just a few of you. I wish I had some images. Well, any of you know anything about the iceberg, you can see the top of the iceberg, but that may be about 10% of the actual iceberg. The rest of it is underwater. I want to talk to you tonight about your reputation versus your character. What's above water, what everybody sees, that's your reputation. Your reputation is what got you here. But character is everything that's underneath the water. Character is all of that makes you. Character is your substance. And so I want to know tonight, are you an R or an S? Are you an R or an S? And after you that, I want to know, are you a character? Are you characters? You a character? Are you characters? If you have character, that's going to help you to win. That's going to help you to be successful. But if you are characters, you will not last in your sport. You won't last in the university. You won't last in the classroom. And you will not be successful. Character is what's going to win championships. Characters will be expelled from the university. And so you guys have to learn how to carry yourselves. And one thing I want to tell you about character tonight is that what you won't do is more important than what you will do. And so there's some things that you guys are going to have to give up. And what I've learned is that if you give up, you can go up. How many this morning, she would get the box, she'd open up the box, and guess what? There was nothing in the box. There was nothing in the box. Well, if you guys can understand that concept, that's how we come here to the university. Your gift, your talent, your skill is that box. But your character is what's in the box. And my prayer for you is that I hope what's in the box is just as big as the box itself. Otherwise, you've got an oversized gift, and you've got to make sure that your gift is not bigger than your character, because your character has to be able to fit inside that gift. Otherwise, your talent brought you here, but your character is the only thing that can keep you here. And so I want y'all to say something with me. If it is to be.
If it is to be.
Oh, y'all got to have more music. I know y'all tired. If it is to be.
If it is to be.
It's up to me.
It's up to me.
Say it one more time. If it is to be.
If it is to be.
It's up to me.
It's up to me.
You've got to make the decision now. to figure out how you're going to be remembered. It was full of excuses, and sometimes if we be honest, we're full of excuses too. But Jesus didn't take an excuse. He gave him a challenge, and I'm going to give you a challenge tonight. He told him, the man hadn't moved for 38 years. He told him, rise, take up your bed and walk. And the man responded. Tonight, you guys have to learn how to respond. Life is all about responding to the challenge and doing the thing that you thought was impossible. And I wonder tonight, can you do the thing that you came here that you thought was impossible? Don't fail this test. Don't fail this test.
Academic success, it's character success, has been mentioned to you. If you've been in one of my classes, you've heard this. I am interested in what you are going to become, but I'm way more interested in who you're going to become. The what's of the world are your positions. The who's of the world are the people. And trust me, people are going to change the world for the better. Not positions, not power, but people. We want you to contemplate the who you want to become. And we want you to carry that out to whatever the what is. So spend some time working on that character. Spend some time contemplating integrity and ethic and passion. Spend time working on those things.
Cap rocks firm foundation. Jesus sky of blue. Sands are on the water. Wave and truth.
Thank you all.